In April 2021, India faces a lethal second wave of COVID-19. Cases rise to over 3 lakhs a day. The demand for life-saving oxygen surges across the country.
I spoke to the Prime Minister and offered Odisha's help.
Technicals nag is resolved.
Got vehicles accompany the tanker.
COVID provided an opportunity for Odisha to be a part of a mission to save people's lives across the country. Please see that emergency measures are taken to help the patients in spite of the logistics constraints. The task force will have to ensure.
Orissa embarks on a massive mission to dispatch oxygen on an urgent basis. A task force comprising government agencies and representatives from industries is set up quickly to execute this vision.
COVID second wave started somewhere around late March, early April, and the number of patients in medical facilities started increasing in leaps and bounds. Medical oxygen demand and supply, there was a tremendous mismatch, what has generally been called the oxygen supply crisis.
Amidst this grim situation, the central government asked states to divert industrial oxygen for medical use. Orissa swings into action.
In pursuance to what directives we received from the Chief Minister of Odisha, the state government had a task force which was the umbrella organization looking into all the requirements and allocation of the resources and planning of movements and dispatches both within the state and outside the state.
Orissa is the metallurgical hub of the country. All that goes into steel making we have in Odisha. In the year 2020, we produced about 20 million tons of steel and 100 million tons in the year 2030 is the target.
In the last 20 years, our steel production has increased by more than 10 times. This expansion in steel capacity gave Orissa the buffer to mobilize oxygen in large scale in a short time to help states in need.
Orissa was in a unique position because these industries, they use industrial oxygen.
Orissa has nearly 70 industries, including large steel plants at vital locations. Steel plants use oxygen as part of their production process. Medical oxygen is more refined because it goes inside a human being. Liquid medical oxygen has a purity level of 99.5%. Transportation of LMO is immensely challenging. It requires cryogenic tankers to keep it stable at an extremely low temperature of minus 182 degrees Celsius.
Through our dashboard, we have been monitoring this whole oxygen logistics for more than a month now, right from the time the second wave set in and the demand for oxygen had risen. And we have an elaborate system where we mapped each and every activity right from, you know, the point where the LMO is manufactured, where 5 steel plants are there. Then the second level is that of the refillers.
This LMO that comes from the production side is refilled in cylinders of different capacities. That's called the refilling stage or refilling stations.
जैसे आप पीछे देख रहे हैं जो लोडिंग चल रहा है ये माइनस 183 डिग्री टेम्परेचर में अभी लोडिंग चल रहा है और हम लोग आर्मी की तरह दिन रात हम लोग सेवा देने के लिए यहाँ पे हैं, ताकि ऑक्सीजन में कोई दुविधा ना हो और पेशेंट तक हम लोग ऑक्सीजन पहुँचा सकें। ये हमारा पहला मोटो है, कोई भी पेशेंट हमारे लिए कोई भी दुविधा में ना आए।
Government agencies, industries and individuals work hand in hand to ensure that the supply chain is unbroken. Empty tankers and cylinders that are needed for the oxygen to be filled are brought in from different parts of the country.
Tankers were arriving in Odisha by air through the Air Force Globemasters. Tankers were arriving by train in rakes, and tankers were arriving by road.
The tankers are escorted by teams of Odisha police to ensure unhindered movement from the loading points up to the state boundary locations. A green corridor is set up.
Routes were mapped. On those routes, the bottleneck areas were chalked out, and arrangements were made to ensure that there is real-time monitoring of these locations. The police teams were primarily the ground-level mechanism to execute the tasks that are set out for us.
My Indica driver Ajay Kumar Singh, oxygen bharke KPO Kalinga Nagar. से विशाखापट्टनम के लिए रवाना हो चुका हूं। मैं पूरे भारत में ऑक्सीजन का सप्लाई करता हूं। हमको मदद करने का ये मौका मिला, मैं उड़ीसा गवर्नमेंट और उड़ीसा प्रशासन का हार्दिक अभिनंदन करता हूं।
देखिबा को मिलितला बात्या याश भयंकर रूप।
On May 26th, a very severe cyclonic storm, Cyclone Yas, hits Odisha and threatens to disrupt the mission.
Cyclone Yas, which was predicted to make a landfall in West Bengal, pretty much accounted for a very large coastline. And the Kalinganagar steel plant hub, which happens to be the steel making hub of the country, came in the direct path. So if you have high wind and rainfall, then what happens is disruption to the power supply. But since they were coming in the path, there was quite possible that it could go down. So therefore, they were on grid support. So this is number one. Number two, for the movement of tankers, you need to have clear roads, which means you have to have the tree cutting, tree felling, tree movement teams available on the road. Number three, you may have any number of disruptions to the traffic by virtue of this crisis. So you have to have police parties.
We had a directive from the Chief Minister's office that even during the cyclone, this movement should go on unhindered, and mechanisms should be put in place for that. It was ensured that all dispatches that could go right before the onset of the cyclone were dispatched early on, and hospitals and other centers were provided with oxygen.
Sir, technical snag is resolved.
Now ensure that escort vehicles accompany the tanker. Alert everyone along the route.
Today we got a panic call, and after getting instruction from our senior officer, we rushed to the spot and cleared all the line. Now we are here and we passed the vehicle, crossed the border. I am very much privileged to be a part of this special cell made to monitor all the vehicles who are carrying liquid medical oxygen.
If you look at our daily transportation, on the day next to the cyclone, we had the third highest supply of oxygen even during the cyclone period.
ये जो सिचुएशन आज खड़ी हुई है सारे दुनिया के सामने, वो हम लोग ये कभी सोचे नहीं थे कि ऐसे कभी सिनेरियो आएगा, और उसके साथ जो ऑक्सीजन को महजूद रखने के लिए जो सारे टास्क फोर्स जो सारे वर्कआउट किए हैं, तो इसके कारण अभी तक ओडिशा में ऑक्सीजन का डेफिशिएंसी अभी तक हम नहीं देखे हैं।
It was a round-the-clock, complicated logistics exercise. We are happy that we could ensure that there were no oxygen-related issues.
During the peak COVID time, Odisha helped Delhi as well as other states for the oxygen, which helped them to tide over the crisis during that time.
In the last 45 days, we have been able to transport more than 28,000 tons of liquid oxygen. Oxygen was not an industrial crisis. It was a humanitarian crisis. But an industrial capacity base could be used to solve a humanitarian crisis overnight. Saying that we are producing 20 million tons of steel in a year to saying that we are saving lives, I can't express it in words, the kind of satisfaction we had for our limited contribution.
In under 2 months, Odisha sent over 28,000 metric tons of oxygen to 17 states. A mission that saw 143 Indian Air Force sorties, 159 trips by special oxygen trains, 1,665 tankers dispatched, and a team that worked relentlessly to try and ensure that oxygen reached those who needed it most.